My name is Raymond, and today I'll just be going really quickly over how to turn your PDFs into HTML5 publications. So, where do you actually get it? You will need to first go to our website, so www.flipcreator.net, and then it'll take you to a homepage. So what you see on screen is our homepage. Then you can just navigate all the way over here to download. And then, so after you have downloaded Flip Creator and installed it, you can run it. When you run it, if it's mine's registered, so you don't see it, but if you're using the free trial version, every time you start up, a little prompt will show up letting you know, do you want to use it as a trial? Do you want to register it or buy it? Once you register it, that prompt will disappear and it will unlock the version for you. So as you can see, I have the global version installed. So to start off, this is what you see once you first start off Flip Creator. So to do that, create your first publication, just click on new. Then you can just choose any PDF that you want to turn into a flipbook. So I have here a PDF. And then now all you have to do is just sit here, let it load. And pretty much once the PDFs are loaded in, as you can see really quick, there are different methods of loading it in, or not methods, more like options. You have regular JPEG, which is just really low quality images, or you can do vector graphics. Those are a little higher quality images, but those will take a lot longer to actually import. So if you have a really large PDF with a lot of pages, you will have to set aside quite a bit of time if you want to import the PDF in. Okay, after your PDF has been imported and everything is extracted, you will see something like this. When I go to publishing, it's pretty much what I've gone over before. Specify a book name, so I can just do HTML5 demo. That's my book, HTML5 demo, and that's the book name I want to call it. I specified an output folder. It's going to be in my E drive, the demo folder, and what I mainly will be talking about will be include mobile support. This is what I want to go over, because most people tend to read publications not sitting in front of a computer anymore or having a laptop. Most people now have either tablets or iPhones and Android phones. So mobile devices has become fairly popular among people. So a lot of people have mobile devices on them, so they tend to want to read publications using mobile devices. So if you check this off and you click publish now, it will publish the regular flash files for regular computers, but since I checked that off, it will generate an extra set of HTML5 files. So now if I go into open folder, I can see the regular SWF files. These are just for computers, and then a bunch of HTML5 files. These are used for viewing on mobile devices, because mobile devices do not support Flash. So that's why we have this option, so we can generate an extra set of HTML5 files for mobile devices, so you can actually read the same publication on a mobile device. That's just the files. Now I'm going to go over some other things you can do. So if I open up to how to view on mobile devices, there are several different methods to view the book on mobile device. One being, if you have all these files, all you have to do is just pretty much upload this entire folder onto your website and just open it through a web browser like you would on a regular computer, but instead, when you open it on a mobile device, it'll just use the HTML5 files instead of the Flash files, like it would on a regular computer. So that's just the normal way of doing it. But what if you want to, read it offline? Well, we have an app for that. We have Flip Explorer. This is a free app that we have on the App Store or the Google Play Store that you can download. And this pretty much is an app that allows you to pretty much import your books into that app, and then you will be able to read the same publication offline. So, how do you do that? So, first, you have to go back to this output folder. Like I said before, when you want to put it on your website, you pretty much just upload this entire folder, the HTML5 demo folder, directly onto your website. And then you just get a URL and it'll access all these files. Same thing when you try to view it offline, except this time, instead of uploading online, you put it into the app. So to do that, you're gonna right click and then you click Add to Archive. And then you just simply create a zip. Just zip up the entire output folder, like so. And then all you have to do is download this app. And for iPhones, you'll have to do it through iTunes. And for Android device, you can just do it through plugging in your Android phone or tablet or whatever, and then just navigating to the offline folder. And then you will be able to just drag the entire zip, this entire zip, into the folder. And then when you run this app, run Flip Explorer on your phone, it will detect the zip that you just imported in, and it'll ask you, you have a new publication, do you want to import it now? And then all you have to do is just click Import. It'll unpack all those files, it'll know what to do with the files, and then you'll see an interface similar to this. So this interface you see there has been five different books that have been imported. So all you have to do is just import it in, and then you'll get it'll show up in the menu like this. And if you have multiple books, imported multiple books, all you have to do is just click on the one you want to read, and then you can read it offline. It'll look the same as if you were reading it through a web browser, but this one just does not require an internet connection to read. So that's just a pretty much quick way to how to on how to read your publication offline.